I know what to say after that one. Holy moly, it was like two different halves. We really controlled the ball in the first half and scored every possession. I was a little disappointed we had settled for a field goal. We tried to run the counter play down there close and settled for a field goal, but the guys did a great job getting touchdowns and getting that lead. That was the difference in the game. And great opening drive in the second half, and you know, give Liberty credit. They did a good job. They our defense really played well in the first half, and we could see that kid was going to be tough to tackle. I mean, I talked to Nate at halftime. He said, "Coach, he's done that to everybody all year." I said, "No, I know, but I don't think he still needs to do that to us. It's not a rule that he's got to make everybody miss." But he sure did. He was hard to bring down, and he made something out of nothing a couple of times. And they made some circus catches that extended drives, and they got some really skilled, talented players, and he's one of them. It's very apparent why he's going to be a first-round draft pick. But in the second half, they had two quick scores on us after we got that touchdown, and then the defense really, really started to get some pressure on him and make him throw it when he didn't want to, breaking the pocket, getting him out there on the run. And we benefited from a couple of drop passes by them, and I got fortunate there a couple of times. We were just able to hold the ball hostage in the second half. We didn't score but the one touchdown, but we were just controlling the clock and keeping it away from them, and it was enough to win. So I was really proud of our players. I think they've got a good football team, and our players knew that. We talked about it all week what the challenge was going to be, playing a good football team on the road. And so, really great effort. I thought our coaches had a really good plan, and fortunately it was enough to win.
Ken Kreitzer.
Coach, congratulations. Ken Kreitzer, SEL Radio. Today you got a couple of long passing plays, the touchdown pass to Brandon Murphy, and then the 51-yarder to Tyrell Robinson. How did you feel that? Was that part of the plan to supplement the running today with passes when you got the opportunity?
Well, not necessarily. I mean, I don't know that we ever think about throwing the ball. We're thinking about trying to run it and how we can run it more effectively. But sometimes it's just the fact that we get ourselves in a position where we got to throw it, or they're committing so many guys and really, especially on the back end, the corners, the safeties are so close to the line of scrimmage and they're so committed to the run or the action that we're giving them that the passes are there. We've got to do it. We got to do it to slow them down and back them up so that we can run the ball and not have those guys poking their nose in the B gap and the C gap, which they were. But the first touchdown pass is a really, really great throw. Finding that guy isn't easy. He was rolling to his right. He had to throw back across the field. And Brahim made a really nice catch, reached up there and caught it at his high point. And so we made some decent plays in the passing game. We didn't throw it a bunch, but when we did, we made it count.
And Coach, on fourth down, I believe you stopped him four out of five times. One was that play Eric Smith.
Two for seven.
I'm sorry?
We were 2 for 7.
Oh, yeah. I was thinking you stopped them. The play Eric Smith made in the end of the first quarter, tackling Malik Willis out of bounds. There were two other players about to get him, too. And then the two interceptions, you had Bo Nicholas, Paul, and then late Jabari Moore really contributed.
Well, the first interception by Bo was on a fake punt, and he made a good play. We were going after him, and they tossed it out there, and we weren't in a press technique, so he was able to see the throw and break on it, and it was a really nice play. And then the interception at the end there, Jabari was really smart to go down. I was hoping he'd run that thing back for a score. I hate to give him the ball back. So it's probably a smart move on his part.
Thanks, Coach.
Joe, go ahead.
Good afternoon, Coach Monken. Congratulations on the win. Joe Iacono with GoBlackKnights.com. Offensive line was opening some really nice holes for the fullbacks and as well as the quarterback in the slots in the first half. What's your assessment of the offensive line's play today?
They did a good job, and their defense is making it tough on us. They're popping a lot of linebackers and bringing edge pressure, And they ran us down from the backside a couple of times. The quarterback pulled the ball and was trying to run around one end, and they tracked him down from the backside. It's hard to get all those guys cut off. So we changed the formation and tried to get other guys involved so that we could make that edge a little bit longer. There were times where we weren't getting the backside A gap and B gaps cut off and getting the backside scooped. They'd run linebackers through and we weren't getting them down. But it's hard to do that every single time. And give them credit that the scheme that they played today, Jack Curtis, who I've mentioned to you guys, was on our staff at Georgia Southern, was our defensive coordinator, and has been at Tulane the last several years, has faced this offense and faced us. That was essentially his plan. And it's a good plan. They've done a good job defending us. And so, I mean, he understands the offense, and they spit those guys out of there a few times when we needed it. And like I said, it was enough for us to win.
Thanks. And then my final question, obviously Malik Willis made some really athletic plays on their side of the ball, as well as some of their receivers, but it looked like Coach Woody had a really good plan in place, and you guys had multiple people applying pressure on defense on all the plays. Could you talk a little bit to the scheme that Coach Woody put in place for this game to at least try and slow that offense down?
Coach Woody's a tremendous defensive coordinator, and we got a good staff, and they know each other well, and they know the defense and how to fix the problems. And we did try to put pressure on him. We brought corners, we brought safeties. I mean, that guy is just unbelievable. I don't know that I've ever seen a guy get so many hands on him and not go to the ground. He just, like I said, I can see why he's going to be a first-round draft pick. We put some pressure on him. What was most impressive is how he got away from it and still was able to deliver the ball and put the ball on the money. And they made some circus catches, as I said, to extend drives. And we were fortunate because he put the ball on money a couple of times. And, that one, they did a double move in that last drive, and they were behind us. And I started thinking that, holy smokes, they score there. They're going to kick an onside kick. They got plenty of time the way that kid operates. So our kids played their butts off. They played hard. And, as I said, he's made a lot of guys miss. He made our guys miss today too, but we got him down enough. We got him into those fourth down situations, as Ken was talking about, and we got him off the field most of the time in fourth down. But he was aggressive right from the start, and I kind of figured he would be as the game went throughout. So we were too. A couple times there on fourth down, I thought about going for it, but I can't say enough for the job that Zach Harding did. I mean, he punting the ball, he made a huge difference in the game for us, and frankly had as much of a part in that second half and us being able to hold them off and win the game as anybody.
Thanks, Coach.
Sal?
Hey, Coach, can you talk about Andre Carter's impact on this game? He may not have had a sack, but he certainly pressured Willis a lot and got him to move off his line a little bit.
He did, and he drew, I think, late. It was him that drew the holding calls. So he's such a good player. People that are going to try to block him, they got to account for him wherever he is, wherever he aligns. So I know that, we didn't get to him as often as we had hoped to and get him on the ground, but he got squirted out of that pocket and had to run toward the sideline and throw across his body a couple of times. Andre put some pressure on him that caused him to do that. And there were other guys too.
Can you talk about the mindset of this team since the Wake Forest game? They made a pledge to win out. And it seems like, it's been it's always a team effort for Army, but it seems like it's been a focus effort since that game.
Well, it's just a pledge that we weren't going to beat ourselves. Somebody's going to beat us. They're going to have to line up and beat us, but not make the mistakes that we can control that cost you football games. And Paul Johnson was my mentor for a long time, 13 years, and he always said the best way to win a game is not to lose it. And he's right. And when you make silly mistakes, fundamental errors, the mistakes with assignments, not not playing the gap you're supposed to play, or blocking the right guy, or covering the right man, or whatever it may be, those things can cost you dearly, and they can cost you a football game. So really the pledge was not to make those errors and to do everything we could in our control to win the football games.
Ken?
Congratulations, Jeff. Julian McDuffie obviously did not play. So, you know, how'd you feel like the secondary performed today?
I thought they did a good job. That's, he threw for a bunch of yards still, but that's a tough offense to defend. They broke on some passes, broke up some plays. Obviously got the pick there at the end. It's hard. It's hard. They're very skilled. It's hard to cover those guys every single play. But we kept them in front of us for the most part. The one, like I said, was that drop down there on the sideline that they got behind us. The holding call there in the fourth quarter, they threw it for a touchdown pass, but the holding call got it back. Those are really the only two times that they got behind us deep. And that, you know, that's a good job by those guys, because it's hard to just play back and keep everything in front of you and still be able to break on the passes in front of you and break it up and discourage throws into your zone or discourage throws to your man. So I thought those guys did a good job.
Can you talk about Coach Freeze going for it around midfield four consecutive times there in the first half? Were you a little bit shocked or no?
No, he's an aggressive coach. And when you play against a team that, like us, it's going to run the ball and hold the ball for a long time. I mean, all he's got to do is look at the stats, and we hold it for 36, 37 minutes a game. So he probably figured his opportunities were going to be limited and took his chances. So, I hats off to him for trying it. A lot of people won't try it. But if he punted it to us, I mean, the result wasn't going to be any different in the first half. And we were putting together drives, and we're able to move the football, and I think that's certainly justified on his behalf to go for it there.
Mm-hmm. Jeff, you always talk about you don't think about anything except the next game. Well, guess what? Navy's the next game. You got momentum. You're playing well. Can you give us an early thought on facing Navy in 2 weeks?
We're going to try to do our very best to not let Army beat Army, and that's to play our assignments, play great fundamentally, take care of the ball, do all the things that we can control, and just try to play as well as we're capable of playing. That's how the game is won. It's not won on emotion. There's going to be plenty of that. Both teams will be excited, and I know that it'll be a all-out bloodbath. They're playing really well, and they got a physical team, and Kenny does a great job with the culture of their program, and it's just going to be a fight. It always is. So I hope that we'll be able to go all the way to the end and find a way to be the winner of the game.
But there is something to be said about momentum. You guys are playing good ball right now. It has to feel much better going into that game playing the way you are right now.
You know what I think about momentum? You never lose momentum if you always believe. So it doesn't matter win, lose, or in between. If you always believe, then you always have momentum.
Thanks, Jeff.
We'll close out with Ken Kratzer.
Coach, just ask about your offensive line. The defensive tackles for Liberty were huge, over 300 pounds each. How did you feel your offensive line did facing a very good defensive tackles? You ran the ball over 60 times. And also Jordan Law went down at one point in the game. I wonder if he's okay.
Jordan, he'll be okay. And I thought the guys did a good job. It was a combination of their defensive line and their linebackers, both their inside and their outside linebackers. And it's tough. It's just tough to knock them out of there every single time. They got good players. And I've talked to other coaches that played against them this year, and what they talked about were their front seven. They really felt like that was the strength of their defense. And they were good players. And Jack had them schemed up. There were times where we really, really ran the ball well, and times where they played off of blocks, and we didn't get the job done, but enough so that we were able to control the clock and win the football game. And that's what's important. I mean, we didn't put up huge numbers in the run game, but as you asked about, we supplemented it with some good passing and kept some drives alive and scored a touchdown on a long pass. So it was what we needed to do to win the football game.
Thanks, Coach.